Still looking? Take your time, no hurry. Take your time.
It's the type of place that would seem to be forever stuck in another era, during a time when our country moved a lot slower, and we all were a little closer.
Would you guys like cream with your coffee?
Mel's Chatham Diner. Halfway between the big city and Amish country lies a comfort zone for those who pass through on their way to life's appointments.
Known for good home-style cooking.
Richie Chase runs the place, and along with his family, he helps serve the folks who open up the menu.
Oh, let's see, we've got the Country Club, BLTs, chicken sandwiches, all grilled.
Along with the club sandwiches and the hash browns, you'll find one special order in memory of one very special guy.
We have what we call the Richie Stewart hat trick, which is three hamburger patties, three slices of cheese.
His name was Richie Stewart, a young man with a lot of talent, tons of promise, and a heck of a lot of friends. Rich Chase was one of those friends, sharing the sport of hockey with young Richie, and a lot of good times.
Richie just was always lighting up the room, and was always the center of attention, and just all over the board, as I say. You know, he's just a fun, happy-go-lucky kid.
He didn't care what other people thought of him. And because he didn't care, everybody cared about him.
Young Richie Stewart starred on the ice at Upland Country Day School. Coach Court Dunn says the game that Richie loved was just one of the ways that Stewart brought people together.
But I always remember my first year. And I remember what he did for me my first year and how much fun he made it. And I remember how much fun playing ice hockey should be.
Stewart first laced up the skates at the age of 7, and he never let go. He was a natural team leader, and his skills on the ice as sharp as the blades on his feet.
It was a phenomenon. He was just unbelievable. I mean, he was big guy, and for a defenseman, scoring hat tricks was just, you know, pretty much unheard of.
9 times out of 10, if you said, we need a goal, you know, within the next 5 minutes, he would go out there and do it.
Childhood friend Tom Halstead knew just how good Richie was. As young teenagers, the two friends won a televised shootout on the ice at the famous Spectrum in Philadelphia, the home of Stewart's beloved Flyers.
Rich Stewart with a game tied at 3 against Mitt Pence, Corky Spillman. Stewart in, he's got the right hand forehand drive to the backhand, he scores!
And Richie and I were just like, we thought this was the coolest thing ever. We're going to be on TV, we get to play in the Spectrum on the Flyers ice, you know, where all our idols played. And I could say it's probably not because of my goaltending, it's because Richie could pretty much score on demand.
But the man that coached young Richie says what made him so special was when he was off the ice. In fact, it seemed you wouldn't even know he played. His mind and his heart was somewhere else.
He was so respectful of everyone. Kind, compassionate, generous, and he was a great hockey player. He certainly had no ego whatsoever.
But Richie's time on the ice was special. He was a force, and his teammates looked to him to score, and he scored often.
He was a very, very strong skater with a really powerful shot, but he scored goals by the bucketful.
He also had a flair for the dramatic. After tying Upland's single-season scoring record with 42 goals, his first-year coach got nervous.
First period came and went, no goal. Second period came and it was about halfway through, and he still hadn't scored yet. And I didn't know whether to leave him on the ice, in which case he'd be tired, or pull him off, and I knew if he was sitting on the bench, he was not going to score. In Richie's way, he made sure that I never had to make that decision. He scored on the next shift out, and we got a nice picture of it. And we had a nice celebration in the locker room afterwards.
Stewart's scoring skills landed him in New Jersey at the Lawrenceville School, where he became known as the franchise, becoming team captain in his junior and senior years before heading off to Division I St. Lawrence College with his star power seemingly on the rise.
The coaches liked him. His teammates liked him. The referees liked him. Even the players on the other team liked him. I mean, everybody liked Richie.
Though the sport of hockey brought him notoriety and records, Stewart never considered his playing days as his glory days. When his career was over, he hung up the skates, but not his helping hand. Stewart eventually landed in New York, taking a job with the brokerage firm Cantor Fitzgerald. And though his weeks were certainly demanding, on Friday nights he found his way at a church on the Upper East Side to feed the homeless. With no one ever knowing, he played the game.
As much as we were really close, he was quiet about it. He didn't do it for attention. He did it because it was something he wanted to do.
He was generous to a fault. I mean, he really did. He epitomized the whole concept of looking after your friends first. I mean, if there was ever a true personification of the word altruistic, that was Richie.
When asked about his gracious manner of helping people, Stewart often told his friends to do the right thing when no one is looking. That's the true meaning of a hero. Those words would be something that young Richie's friends would remember that day in September.
The second tower, which in fact was the first one hit, collapsed as well.
Richie Stewart was gone. Moments after the first plane hit the North Tower of the World Trade Center, the 35-year-old broker, with a passion for family, called his parents from his office on the 104th floor. As the smoke and the tears filled his eyes, he told his father this.
Tell Mom I love her. I'm okay. But we have to go now. The room is filling with smoke. And he said he would call back, but he never called back.
The tragedy on that September day took a piece from all of us. But for the friends and those who knew young Richie Stewart, life without him seemed unimaginable.
It was devastating. It was absolutely devastating.
I can't imagine, you know, I just can't imagine.
Nine days following the attacks in New York City, in a moment of inspiration, Rich Chase gathered his buddies, bought a ticket, and headed to South Philadelphia to honor his friend at a game they both loved. It was to be the first hockey game played after the events of 9/11. Stewart's hometown Flyers were on the ice with the team from New York. And with the game tied after two periods, something came from above.
President Bush came on the Arena Vision.
It will not end until every terrorist group has been found, stopped, and defeated.
With those words, the game was called, and as the players left the ice, a warm sense of patriotism filled the building. It was the perfect time for Chase and his buddies to salute young Richie. It's the enormity of a loss that we still can't quite understand. Life in sport teaches us to be resilient, move on, but never forget. For those friends of young Richie Stewart, he'll be the plaque on a wall, the smile in the photo, and he'll take his special place on the menu. Because he's with them every day in every way.
I think he'd be glad to be on the menu, and we're glad to have him on the menu.